sure all of our cattle are doing good, especially during calving season. And so today I'm going to teach you the simple and easy way to saddle a horse. So this right here is going to be my demo, being that I didn't bring a horse today. So we'll just kind of keep along with that. But three main items that you need a brush in order to clean your horse off, a saddle pad, and I'll kind of explain what that is, as well as a saddle. The first thing you want is a soft bristled brush. This you can find just about anywhere at any feed store and a lot of your small towns. And it's really important that you brush your horse all over, but primarily along the back as well as right behind the shoulder, which are going to be right here in these two areas, because that's where your saddle is going to sit. And with the less dirt is the less friction, and the less that your horse is going to get rubbed. So you're kind of looking out for your horse in that sense. And moving on to the saddle pad, there's all sorts of types of saddle pads that you can get, but relatively they look very similar to this. It's important that you place them on top of the withers, and that is this area right here. It's right where your cervical vertebrae and your thoracic vertebrae come in. It's right there, basically sits like right on the back of your neck. And so the reason you want to set it there is because when your horse is taking off, you're running or whatever you're doing, you're kind of at the forefront of your horse and you not get left behind. So if your horse decides to take off and get a good run, you don't fall off the back end. So it's very important that you set it there. But the purpose of the saddle pad is to protect and support the horse, as well as count as a buffer in between the saddle and your horse. So it just protects and supports and gives your horse a good cushion. A side note, when you go to unsaddle, when you take your saddle pad off, horses like to sweat a lot, and it's very important that the sweat covers all along their back. If they have pinpoints, that means that your saddle or your saddle pad doesn't fit properly on your horse. And so it's very important that sweat covers everything, and because everything's fitting correctly. All right, so back to our final item that you'll need is your saddle. And so just like the saddle pad, you're gonna wanna set it right here on the withers. And the first thing that you're gonna do is tighten the front cinch, which is this right here. And you wanna tighten this first because it is gonna be your tightest cinch between your two. And if your horse is to get spooked or like to walk off as you're saddling, that's gonna be the tightest, and therefore it's less likely to fall off and break. It's also very important that when you swing and put your saddle on your horse, that you're as gentle as possible. A saddle weighs anywhere from 40 to 60 pounds, and so the last thing you want to do is just plop it right on top and hurt your horse's back. So it's very important that you're gentle about that. And lastly, the last thing you're going to want to do is tighten the back cinch. The back cinch, you're going to want to be able to put about a hand in it. It doesn't need to be too tight, but just to ensure that your saddle isn't going up and down, that it is nice and secure on, but it's not